Welcome to The Truth About Lending. I'm Melinda Payne, the president and owner of The Truth About Lending. I've been a licensed mortgage broker for over 25 years and bring you clear and straightforward insights on everything from securing your initial home purchase to refinancing your house or obtaining condo financing in Florida's dynamic lending market. Now let's get into The Truth About Lending. No, you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place your home. Welcome to this week's Mortgages with Melinda. I'm Melinda Pan, owner of The Truth About Lending, and today we're going to talk about a candid discussion about VA loans and the unfortunate discrimination that many veterans face when putting in an offer using the VA financing. Guys, everyone knows how difficult it is for a veteran to get a VA loan accepted, an offer that's using a VA loan accepted. And why is that? And what can we do to try to change that? You know, there really has been a tremendous amount of discrimination that unfortunately our veterans have faced over the years. And honestly, I really think that there needs to be a lot better education from NAR, from the National Association of Realtors, to their members, because there's this big misconception that using VA financing is a lot higher of a risk than if somebody was using conventional financing or FHA financing. And the reason why is because VA financing doesn't require any down payment. Well, guys, I understand that there are some veterans that may choose to put no money down. There's a lot of veterans that do put money down, okay? And they still want to do VA financing. Why? Because the interest rate is the lowest interest rate out of all of the different financing types. So whether it's FHA, conventional, or Fannie Mae, Fannie Mae is conventional. The lowest interest rate of all of the loan types is VA loans or RVA loans. So you're looking at an interest rate that's significantly lower than conventional or FHA. So you may have a veteran that is putting a down payment, but still wants to do a VA loan. Now, when we're talking about veterans and not putting any money down, I want everyone out there to remember that yes, sometimes veterans may not put a down payment, but they put their life at risk servicing our country. And because of that, they have that right. And so I really want everyone out there to understand that this is a big problem. And it's really a form of discrimination. In my opinion, if a person has really put their life on the line to serve our country, they should have the right to be able to buy a house without any type of discrimination as to the type of financing. Now, personally, I feel that there should be a complete removal of the type of financing that is allowed with a listing. So for example, you should be able to just advertise that the property is either accepting a financed buyer or not, and not specifically the type of financed buyer. I really think that that's just none of the seller's business as to the type of financed buyer, but that's my opinion. The bottom line is that buying a house with a VA loan is not more difficult or challenging than buying a house with a conventional loan from the perspective of the appraisal, okay? In fact, there is an easier process, believe it or not. I know a lot of people don't realize this. It's actually easier to get an appraisal back. It's quicker and you have more communication with a VA appraiser than you would with an appraiser that's doing a conventional or FHA loan. Why is that the case? Because the VA has something called the Tidewater Act, or invoking Tidewater. What does that mean? And have you ever heard of that before? Well, guys, what that means is that if a VA appraisal is done, and if the appraiser feels that the property is not going to appraise for the purchase price, they are required by law, okay, required by law to reach out to either the realtor, the loan officer, somebody that's involved in the transaction and say, hey, I'm invoking Tidewater, which means that you've got 3 business days to provide comparable homes or comps to be able to show the appraiser to convince him that the house is worth whatever it is that the house is under contract for. And that pertains to whether it's a dollar below the appraised value or $10,000 below. So if a property is listed for $500,000 and it's appraising for $499,999, they still have to invoke the Tidewater Act. Or if it's going to appraise for $480,000, they still have to invoke the Tidewater Act. This doesn't exist with conventional loans. This doesn't exist with FHA loans. It's basically a way that the veteran has to be able to really try to get their house in the best possible way. So an appraisal for a veteran versus an appraisal for an FHA buyer or a conventional buyer is not harder. It's not stricter. The only difference is with a VA loan, a termite inspection has to be done. Now, listen, most buyers are doing their own termite inspections anyways. That's the only difference when it comes to properties. Okay, guys. So it's very important that we understand that veterans put their life on the line for us. This is a very passionate thing that I am just completely disgusted by, that there's so much discrimination that goes on against VA buyers. My father is a disabled veteran. My son is a veteran. My grandfather was a veteran. This is really something that is close to home, as it should be with every single American. There shouldn't be this level of discrimination against VA buyers. So if you're out there and you're being told by somebody, by an agent, not to accept offers from a veteran, I want you to stand up and say, hey, I'm going to accept VA loans because that person stood up for me and represented me to be able to allow me to have the safety that I have in the United States. So guys, that is my take on VA loans. It's very important that you understand that a VA loan is just as good as any other kind of loan, and in many cases, even better. Okay. So thank you so much for joining us this week. Please make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And also, if you'd like to reach us regarding a VA loan or any kind of loan, you could reach us at 888-76-TRUTH or visit us online at thetruthaboutlending.com. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure you watch us weekly for lots of great information about mortgages and financial planning regarding mortgages as well. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for listening to The Truth About Lending. Stay up to date with all Florida loan and mortgage news by subscribing to our channel and help us grow so we can continue bringing you insight and advice. Please like, share, and follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. You can find the links to all our social media profiles in the description. You can find extra resources on our website, thetruthaboutlending.com. If you have any questions about Florida mortgages, we are licensed and ready to talk to you today. Call us at 888-76-TRUTH. That's 888-768-7884. You can also email us at melinda@ttal.info or visit us at our website, thetruthaboutlending.com. Until next time, remember, the truth about lending is out there for you. No, you're not.